In this video, you're going to learn what, when, and how to optimize regularly in your Google Shopping campaigns. If we want to scale our shopping campaign, we need to work on it daily, weekly, and monthly. This is how we get results like this. See how the growth is consistent over all these months? That's because we regularly worked on and optimized this shopping campaign. In this video, I'm going to show you what you need to do daily, weekly, and monthly to see this continuous growth and optimizations towards profits for your Google Shopping campaign. All the optimizations that you're going to learn in this video are taught in our free Google Shopping course on our website. I'll be linking to a lot of videos down below, so make sure to go and check them out, including a link to the actual course. I'll also leave a link to the actual checklist that we're going to use in this video, so check that out too, so you can use it for your own account. Keep in mind that all the time periods that I'm going to go through in this video are just a guide. You should be optimizing your account when it needs it. These time periods work for a newer account that's not spending a lot of money. But when you're spending $10,000 a day, you'll be spending a lot more time in your account every single day. So the optimizations get sped up a lot more because you have a lot more data to work with. Okay, let's get into it. Here's what we do on a daily basis in our account. First, we check our Google Merchant Center account. Here we're looking for suspensions and disapprovals. We then check our Google Ads account for any billing issues. We then check our campaign to make sure it's getting impressions and clicks. And lastly, we check for any anomalies in the account. Things like big changes in performance that tell us we need to look deeper. Okay, let's go through each one in more detail. First, we check our Google Merchant Center account. Here we want to check if it's been suspended. You'll know you've been suspended because you'll see this big red bar at the top of your dashboard. Plus, you'll also receive an email from Google telling you you've been suspended. We want to fix our Google Merchant Center suspension as soon as possible because as long as we're suspended, our shopping campaigns will stop running. This means no more clicks, no more sales, which is terrible, especially if you've built up your campaign to be a sales generating machine for your e-com store. Fixing your Google Merchant Center suspension is a tough process, and I'll leave some links to some guides below. The next thing we want to check is the diagnostics report for any product errors or disapprovals. Just head to products, diagnostics in your Google Merchant Center account and see if there are any errors, disapprovals, or issues here. Disapprovals look like this, and warnings look like this. We fix these as soon as possible because leaving them as they are is going to give us a higher chance of getting a suspension. I'll leave some more resources down below for fixing disapprovals. The next thing we want to check is our Google Ads account for any issues. We'll especially be looking for any billing issues, like if Google tries to charge our credit card and it fails. This will stop our ads. It will look like this at the top. Just go into settings and billing and pay your bill so that you can get your ads running again. We also want to double check that our shopping campaign is getting impressions and clicks. There could be a multitude of things causing no impressions and no clicks for our shopping campaign. So we want to make sure there are no anomalies here. Here's how to do this.
In your Google Ads dashboard, go here to Google Shopping in the menu on the left. Now set your data graph at the top here to the past 7 days and change the data view to daily. We'll also change the metrics we're looking at to impressions and clicks by doing this. We can now hover our cursor over the graph to make sure that we're getting both on a daily basis. I also like to look at the cost and conversion value on a daily basis to see if there are any anomalies. Anything out of order triggers us to look deeper into it and find a solution. There's always going to be variation in the data, but seeing an unusual break in a pattern can be the early red flag that saves your campaign and your sales.
You'll see that most of our daily checks are to check if there are any drastic things happening to our account. We'll now look at weekly optimizations, which are more focused on improvements. We'll often do some of these daily, like negative keyword mining, but weekly is a good minimum. Here's what we do on a weekly basis. Managing our bidding and bidding adjustments. Negative keywords. Search impression share. The first thing we do in our campaign are our manual bidding adjustments. If you're following through our free Google Shopping course right now, you'll know that at the start of a campaign, we actually run a manual bidding strategy, manage the bids on a product level, and later, once we have enough conversions, we'll change to an automated bidding strategy. So here, we'll do our manual bidding adjustments based on performance on a weekly basis. I'll leave a link below to our full process and guide on how we do this. It's quite a long process, but we break it down for you guys and provide the template to manage your bids. The next thing we do is negative keyword mining. This means combing through your search terms report, which can be found by going to your campaign, keywords, and then search terms. See all these irrelevant search terms? These will be much less likely to get us sales, so we don't want to waste money on more of these search queries. So we add them as negative keywords. This is like pruning a tree over time to make it more beautiful. This is one of the ways that we can scale our campaign by optimizing it to make more and more profits. We have a full guide on doing negative keyword mining. I'll leave a link to that down below. The last thing we want to do on a weekly basis is look at our search impression share. This is a metric shown on the campaign level that shows us how many of the available searches did we show for. If our budget is capped and our campaigns are profitable, this shows us that we can potentially increase the budget of our campaign and make more sales profitably.
We can find this by going to our shopping campaigns on the campaign level, then unhiding the column to show search impression share by going to columns, modify columns, and scrolling down to find competitive metrics and adding in these three metrics: search impression share, search lost IS rank, and search lost IS budget. Click apply. We can then see in this column here, search lost IS budget, if our campaign is not showing for people because we have a too small of a budget. Potentially for this campaign here, we could increase our budget by 15% or more and still get the same results, but get a higher volume of clicks. It basically shows us, is there room to scale this campaign?
Keep in mind that when you start your campaign, Google is still figuring out what your products are, so this metric isn't as useful. This is because it's based on your number of eligible impressions. If Google doesn't know what your products are, it doesn't know what the potential eligible searches would be. So don't get caught up on doing this weekly until your campaign is humming along, it's maxed out the budget, and the campaign is profitable. That's when you consider increasing the budget to scale your campaign. Okay, let's now look at what we do on a monthly basis. Product feed optimizations, device, location, and time of day bidding adjustments. First, the most important thing here is our product feed. As we learn more about our customers and what they use to search Google, we want to be optimizing our product feed. This is quite a technical process, and we have a full guide on how to do this. I'll leave a link to that guide down below. We also want to make sure to check if we can make further optimizations by adding other bidding adjustments. This means checking to see if different devices perform better and bidding higher or lower for these different searches. We'll also adjust our bids based on the location of our traffic and the time of day and the day of the week. Now, a lot of good stuff goes into this process, and I've got a full video guide showing you how to do it. I'll leave a link to that down below. That's what we do on a monthly basis. Though, when we want to look on a quarterly basis, we go on a more macro level. We want to step back and look at other things that could really help our campaigns. Things that require more data, or changes into other areas to see significant improvements. Here we like to go into our Google Ads account and play around with the different metrics and time periods. We're looking for any trends, any seasonality. We'll also take this into account with the time of year that we're currently in. Also looking at Google Analytics and other data such as conversion rate, bounce rates, and anything else we can pull. You never just want to focus your optimizations on your Google Ads account. You should be continuously testing and optimizing your website to get a higher conversion rate over time. Okay, that's all for the optimizations we'll be doing on a regular basis for our shopping campaigns. There's a lot of resources that I mentioned here. I'll leave a link to all of them down below. Plus the full optimization schedule and checklist that you can use for your own account. Now, if you're watching this video on YouTube, it's actually part of our free Google Shopping course on our website. This course is 100% free with everything you need to set up, scale, and optimize your Google Shopping campaigns. I'll leave a link down below so you can go and check that out. If this video was helpful, please give it a like and let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.